Haridwar means entrance of Himalayas. Hari has got 2-3 meaning in Sanskrit. Vishnu is also called as Hari. See one more thing. Krishna says in Gita beautifully, among the hills I am Himachala. I am the Himalayas. Because of that statement, Himalayas is slowly called as Hari. Dwar means entrance. Haridwar means entrance into Himalayas. Today only we entered. Actually, Rishikesh is nearby city is Haridwar. Next city is Rishikesh. Today only we have entered. Tomorrow we are going to go to Yamunotri, where Yamuna starts. Yamuna is the river of Bhakti. See, there are two important rivers of India which represents two different energies. Yamuna represents Bhakti energy. Ganga represents Jnana energy. Ganga is the energy of knowledge, Jnana. Yamuna is the energy of Bhakti. So, where the Yamuna starts, tomorrow we are going to go there. The base camp of Yamuna, we will go and stay tomorrow. And tomorrow we will be having 2-3 sessions of meditation. You will be having a discourse on this Nithyananda Upanishad. I request all of you to put any question on guru-disciple relationship. You can write any question. Why? Who is guru? Who is disciple? What for relationship? What the hell are we doing? What the heaven are we doing? We can't say hell. What the heaven are we doing? And why, what, when, where? All those questions. Any question. You can write and give it to Nitya Advaitananda. He will scan it and give it to me. Now he will give a whole thing, he will arrange it and give me. So, you can write any question tonight itself. On guru-disciple relationship. Don't ask what is Ralgalam. Can I go to start some of my job in Ralgalam? Don't ask all these silly questions. Ask some useful questions. On guru-disciple relationship. Tomorrow we'll be having the discourse and meditations, because tomorrow purposely I told them to keep little free. Morning we'll have a beautiful journey. Tomorrow we are going to travel in, I think, one of the beautiful roads of Himalayas. The Rishikesh to Yamunotri is there. We'll be traveling just along with rivers. Beautiful. Usually always all Himalayan roads are along with rivers, but Yamunotri route is wonderful. That's why this time purposely I added Yamunotri. Last time we did not add Yamunotri. I said no, Yamunotri is something wonderful. We should not miss it. We added. And one more thing, in Himalayas you should understand one important thing. Journey itself is joy. Don't think you will reach the goal and then you will enjoy. Don't expect like Tamil Nadu temples, huge temples. No. There will be small AC sheet roof. That only will be the called as temple. You will be travelling 200-300 kilometers in this hill to see that only. A small deity will be there. That devata also after 3 months they will take away. They will take it and bring it to the Haridwar Rishikesh. Only this 3 months the temple will be open. It will not, you can't even call it as a temple, like a temporary structure. Gangotri and all it will be like a temple. But many places will be temporary structure. It is not the goal. The very path is important. Very path is beautiful. That is why we are traveling in the Himalayas. Tomorrow this is what we are going to do. Day after tomorrow, early morning, we will start from our base camp to Yamunotri. About that tomorrow they will give you instructions. Nobody can imagine people will look so beautiful with Kali. The whole group looks so nice with Kavi. Now I made this cloak as a fashion. Nitya fashions. They have given a new respect to Kavi. Let me say a few words towards about what we did today. Today first thing we did is Shraddha, means giving our gratitude to elders and other five elements. Next, we had Ganga Bath, Ganga Snana. About Ganga, I should say a few words. See, in the ancient time, the rishis wanted to give something to the planet Earth, solid, which will radiate energy forever. Forever it should radiate energy. They tried to create temples. That also, if somebody breaks, nothing can be done. The energy is destroyed. They tried to energize the Agni. If you see the Jwalamukhi temples, have you heard of Jwalamukhi temples? In North India, there is a Jwalamukhi temples. The fire will be there. They try to energize the fire. That also, if it is put off, the energy is disturbed. They tried all the other methods. Finally, only these three you can energize. Water, fire and ether, fire and earth. Other two you can't relate. These three only human beings can relate. So finally they decided, let us energize a whole river so that the energy will be available to the planet Earth forever. So three group of enlightened masters sat in the Ganga. One group in Gangotri, another group in Brahmamunda, Hardwar, third group in Ganga Sagar. It is after all that the river is completely connected. You understand, it is connected. So this all the three group entered into samadhi at a time and brought the energy like a lightning to the river. The whole river got energized. If you read that book, Messages from Water, then you will understand. There is a beautiful research done with water. One doctor, he collected a glass of water and he started repeating the thoughts and creating the waves of love and peace towards that water. After a few days, he freezed that water and started looking through microscope, then took some pictures. Then same way, another glass of water, same quality water, he started using the word war, terrorism, anger. Then he freezed that water also and saw, you will be shocked to see the photographs, the love and peace that looks like a diamond, that photograph, and the war and anger that looks like a diamond. Not one, hundreds of researchers. You don't know the power of words. Through this research they prove, water directly responds to your thoughts. Your thoughts can be stored and radiated by water. The same philosophy of rishis have done. Rishis just energized the whole Ganga. An ordinary doctor chanting 10 minutes love and peace can create so much of vibration means, hundreds of enlightened masters just bump, exploding energy. What would have happened to that river? And still now, millions of people every day stand in that river and say prayers. Not one or two, millions of people. Only in Varanasi, 3 lakh is floating population. Every day, average 3 lakh people take bath in Varanasi Ghats. That's the statistics. Average 3 lakh people every day take bath in Varanasi Ghat. If you see from the Gangotri to Ganga Sagar, it's millions. Millions of people say prayers. Stand in the Ganga and say prayers. The whole, all these positive thoughts energize the whole river. Again and again and again. That is why they say, Ganga is Papa Harini, Sarva Dosha Nivarani. All our sins will be just destroyed. There's a beautiful incident which you all should know about it. British people, when they come from England, they will bring water from England to Calcutta by ship. Whenever they come within 20 days, the water will get spoiled. The last few days they will suffer for water. But whenever they go from Calcutta, they will carry Ganges water only. It will never spoil till they reach England. Not only that, even after 2-3 months it will not get spoiled. Then they started doing research. How can it be possible? When we go to the country, water gets spoiled. Water is spoiled. When we come back from the country, water is not spoiling. And they are surprised. How can this be? Then they started doing research. Finally, they say after the research, Ganga water has got a beautiful quality of purifying itself by itself. If you drop iron piece inside the Ganga, it will simply melt and disappear. No other water can melt in, no other water iron will dissolve. You can try an experiment. Take a bottle of Ganga water tomorrow when you go. Keep it in your house, put a small coin or something. Within 2-3 months it will dissolve and disappear. Actually I was shocked. How can something disappear in water? And if that happens, it's acid. How can it be healthy for drinking? It is neither acid, good drinking water, such wonderful good drinking water, healthy drinking water, but dissolves anything. If the dead bodies are put in the Ganga, bones will just disappear. Bones will just dissolve. You will be surprised. No other water can dissolve the bones. In no other water, bones dissolve. In Ganga, totally it dissolves. Every day at least 2,000 to 3,000 dead bodies are thrown in Ganga. Throughout the Ganga, 2,000 to 3,000 dead bodies. The number which I am giving is without burning. The sadhus, when once they die, their bodies will be directly put in the Ganga. For the sake of crocodiles and the there is one more thing, Magara. They call it Magara. It is a vehicle of Ganga Devi, like a shark. It's an Indian shark. Alligator. Alright. Vehicle of Ganga. That's a vehicle of Ganga Devi. Alligators. So for that, food for alligators. They directly put the body in the Ganga, and after burning, putting the ashes, that is millions, I don't know how many millions, because from all over India, anybody dies, some one person will bring that ash within 13 days and put it in Ganga. I don't know how many millions of people ashes put in the Ganga. If you say body, full body, at least thousands every day, but still it retains its purity to purify the river. So it has to be rejuvenated now. That's the reason master center. They say tirthe kurvandi tirthina. To make the tirtha as a tirtha, they enter into tirtha. You all had a Gangasna. Then what we did is we did Abhishekam or Puja to Anandeshwara. Then we did Vraja Homa. Vraja means burning all the dirts, purifying ourselves. You did the Vraja Homa. I chanted the Vraja Homa mantras. You all offered the Ahudi in that Vraja Homa mantra. Then you had the Yanyogavita, means the sacred thread. It is a protection. Understand, this sacred thread and Kavi is a protection for you for these 15 days. All this nature. Natural elements, they know, oh, Nithyananda Swami's guys, we should not play with them. Just to give them the signal, they are my guys, it's a protection for you. The sacred thread and the Kavi cloth. That sacred thread and Kavi cloth, please wear for next 15 days continuously. When we go back in the Haridwar, we will do a small puja and remove. At that time you can remove. Till then, please wear. Don't throw here and there. Even when you sleep, put on your pillow and sleep. But don't throw the Kavi. It's a big protection. And it's an energy. Usually nobody gives. Somehow I felt, let you all enjoy that experience of Kavi. Because according to color therapy, there's a big system called color therapy. They say that if you, every color has got a capacity of invoking particular mood inside you. If you see any house painted in red, what will you remember? Police station. Yeah? Immediately in India, police station will come to your memory. And they say, if you put a red light in the room, in your bedroom, you will not have a deep sleep. You will have a disturbed sleep. If you put yellow in the light blue you will have a very deep sleep. So every color has got a particular quality which will be invoked in your system. This kavi will invoke, the kavi will create awareness and consciousness inside you. That's the reason I gave you the kavi. So for next 15 days, enjoy the Rishi's life, the life of Rishis. You took all these 5 vows. Let me repeat once more so that you cannot say I have forgotten. Satya means truthfulness. Physically, mentally, verbally, you will be truthful. Even a single word, don't tell a lie. If somebody has time, say, see yourself. See by yourself. Try to be sincere for this 15 days. After this 15 days, it's up to you. 15 days, try to be sincere so that you will have the experience of Rishis. From this place only the Rishi culture started. So let you experience that. The life of Rishis. Satya means physically, mentally, verbally speaking truth. Brahma, then comes Ahimsa. Ahimsa means physically, mentally, verbally you will not hurt anybody. 15 days you cannot fight with anybody. You cannot verbally hurt anybody. Then Asteya, non-stealing. Non-stealing does not mean only not stealing products from others. You will not abuse nature. You will go 1, 2, 3, then only you will enter into Ganga. Without going 1, 2, 3, don't enter into Ganga. Otherwise, even here there will be a special art stream. See, abusing, without going to bathroom, restroom, don't enter into Ganga. Some of you understand, some of you don't. Anyhow, you will not abuse nature. We will not disrespect Himalayas. We will not pollute this beautiful natural surrounding. Asteya means non-stealing and non-disturbing. 15 days we will not abuse this nature so that the nature will bless us. And the next thing, aparigraha, living with minimum things. Living with minimum things. Try to live with minimum things. Then brahmacharya. Brahmacharya means you will not have the fantasies. Renounce what you don't have. You see, Rishis are all brahmacharis. It is not that they are unmarried. They are married, but they don't have fantasy. They have only pure love. They have only pure love. Decide for this next 15 days, I will respect my husband. I will respect my wife. Respect your spouse as a god, as a representative of Shiva or Umadevi. Respect them. That is what is meant by the word brahmacharya. Living with existence. So all of you have taken all these 5 vows. Don't tell, no, I took without knowing Swamiji. You are already taken. Now you cannot do anything. For this next 15 days, you have to follow these vows. Next 15 days, follow these vows. And surely it will do so much of good to your body and mind and your soul. So enjoy the whole Himalayas trip. Tomorrow we will start the Nithyananda, inner science technology, or inner space technology. Tomorrow we will work on the meditation techniques. And I will be answering on questions on guru-disciple relationship. Questions about guru-disciple relationship. This Yajnavita and the sacred thread and the kavi, you should not remove even when you go to bathroom also. Don't think, how can I go with this to the bathroom? When you go to bathroom, you don't remove the guard from your heart and keep it out and go. You carry the guard in your heart. Then why should you remove the kavi? You can go with Yajnavita. Alright. If you are already wearing Yajnavita, this also let it be there. After 15 days, this will you remove. Whatever you are wearing regularly, that let it be with you. That's all. And if you have any doubt about today's program, what we did, if you don't understand anything, if you want to ask any questions, you are welcome. Then we will end the session. After the question, after a few minutes, we will end the session. this Gayatri mantra can be repeated 24 hours mentally. Mentally you can repeat 24 hours. As for now, every day, these 15 days, repeat at least few times. I'll be guiding. Every day we'll all be sitting and chanting few times at least this Gayatri mantra. No. Better say inside the mind. All right, it is time. We'll end the session. Okay. Let's gather for next session. Thank you.